I started out like a lot of women. I went to college, and college was actually my first experience of accumulating my first real world debt. I worked at a financial advisor's office, and he says, you need to create a budget. And then this was the first time anyone ever in my life ever asked me to do that. Not only was it a realization how much I didn't know about personal finance, but it almost made me feel like I was failing in my professional life, because here I was working in the finance industry, supposed to be telling people how to handle their finances, and I didn't even know how to create a budget for myself. When I got divorced, I had to step out into a world by myself on a single income. And no one has all the answers when they start. But if you have the dedication and the drive enough, eventually you'll realize how important self-education is. And that's what I did. I went on the internet, I watched videos. I was determined I'm not gonna be a failure. My process may fail me, but I'm not giving up. And that's ultimately how I learned and went through it.
Joining us from her home in Spokane, Washington, welcome Kumiko Love. Kumiko, let me tell you, you were in the world of finance. You had a finance degree in clients. If I was one of your old clients, I would be like, wait a minute. Kumiko, you didn't know how to do budgeting, but you were giving financial advice. Help me understand that.
Yeah, so really my job in the finance industry, I worked with a financial advisor, and I was kind of there to help him with the paperwork and all of that. I wasn't meeting one-on-one with clients in the very beginning. I definitely got there later on, but it was definitely a journey.
I love that. But the pivotal moment came not from in the office where you were working, as you said, in the financial world in that capacity. It was when you were with your son, James, and you were buying ice cream that cost a little over a dollar, and that created a problem for you. What happened?
Right. So me and my son just got done at the park, and I wanted to take him afterwards to get an ice cream cone. And when I went to go pay through the drive-thru, you know, first thing I did is I went into my wallet to grab my debit card, but I hesitated. I hesitated because I didn't know if my debit card was going to decline. So I naturally got my credit card, and I paid with it with my credit card. And as I'm getting back out into the road, I realized, oh my gosh, I just financed a $1.09 ice cream cone. Wow. And that was my wake-up call that this was not the life I was meant to live. This was not the life I wanted with my son. And that was ultimately my pivoting point.
You know, and you took what you learned in that moment. You're now an accredited financial counselor, and you're the founder of a multi-million dollar company, The Budget Mom. And you think about it, and I see, again, you get emotional. Can I pay for this dollar ice cream cone? And then having the decision, I've got to get myself together. I got to learn how to budget. I got to tackle this. So $80,000 in debt you started to tackle. And here you are now. And there have been life lessons that you've learned, but also advice that you've wanted to share with people. And you have this, what you call your three ways to approach a budget. Walk me and the audience watching through these three ways that you think are pivotal.
Yeah, these were the major aha moments on my journey when I was learning how to manage my money. The first one is not just to create a budget, but to create a realistic budget. Mm. And there is a very big difference. We need to create a budget based on what we are actually spending, not what we want to spend.
Wow.
My second biggest tip is being okay and giving yourself permission to do it your own way. A lot of the times we don't trust ourselves enough to make the decisions that we need to, because we are depending on other people's advice, their knowledge to get us through. And ultimately what I learned is that it's okay to do budgeting in my own way, because ultimately that's the right way to budget.
So you're saying we don't need this rigid way of doing it. You don't have to follow every T or dot the I the way some computer app says you should do it. You should follow instinctively the things that work for you and your family.
Correct. Yes. Absolutely. Look, creating a budget is the most personal thing you will ever create. It's personal finance, which means that it really does have to be a reflection of your own life.
And you learn this all, not from the office, but online. I love it. And speaking of online, we're going to put so much more of her information on our website, Kumiko, thank you so much. And we really appreciate you sharing that story, because I think so many people, I know, especially now, folks will relate to what you experienced and now what you are sharing. Thank you.
Thank you.